Hey there, Shanna here. Welcome to my channel all about finding joy while learning to live well with autoimmunity. I am so glad to have you here. So today I am so excited. I am having one of my best girlfriends on. We are talking about an aspect of my AIP lifestyle. We're talking about essential oils to boost immunity. And my friend is an expert at essential oils. Her name is Mandy, and she has traveled all over the world educating and sharing about the power of essential oils when it comes to health and wellness. So it is such an honor to have you here, Mandy. Thank you.
I love being here with you. This
so is awesome. Exciting.
If this is how we have to hang out, this is how we have to hang out. We have to do webinars together. It's just how it goes.
So kind of a funny story, Mandy's husband and my husband are like, we're like best childhood friends. And he actually introduced me and my husband in high school, was the best man in our wedding. And then within years married Mandy and gave me one of my best friends. So
yay, happy ending.
And then another funny story. So I've been using essential oils for years, and Mandy introduced me to them. My family and I, we were beach camping at the beach, and we were having like a campfire at night, and Mandy and her husband and her kids, four cutest kids you've seen, they came, and we were all around from the campfire. And this was like years and years ago, back when I just had like weird health issues coming and going. I didn't know why. I did not have my diagnosis yet. And one of the weird health issues that I would have pop up was heartburn. I would just get this really, really bad heartburn. And sure enough, it happened. We were hanging out with our friends, and I made some comment about it because it hurt so bad. And they were like, I was kind of embarrassed about it. And they're like, oh, we have something for that. And I was kind of like, they're like, yeah, if you just put some, you know, a couple drops of peppermint essential oil in your water bottle, it will take care of that right away. And I was kind of like, woohoo, like totally skeptical, like you're crazy, but they're my friends, so I did not want to hurt their feelings. So it's like, okay. And so I tried it, and it took away my heartburn so beautifully. And so that was kind of like what got me started. I never heard of essential oils, and that was years ago. I've used them so much over the years, everything from like kids' ear infections to like autoimmune symptoms to just like all kinds of things, health and wellness. And so when, you know, boosting immunity is so important for all of us, especially those with autoimmune conditions, especially with what's going on today. And so I really wanted to invite Mandy, who's like my expert when it comes to essential oils, to share how we can use essential oils as part of our AIP lifestyle. She's going to talk about how we can boost our immune systems using essential oils. So again, thank you, Mandy, and I'll just kind of turn it over to you.
It is my absolute pleasure. You know, I can talk about this for hours, and we don't have hours. So it's going to be hard for me to break it all down, but I did it for you. I went ahead and just broke it down, simplified it enough so that people just get a better understanding about what essential oils are, how we can utilize them into our lives. So just like Shanna, just so you guys are aware, when I was introduced to essential oils, I was that skeptic. I was the one going, oh my gosh, please. You're like testing my intelligence right now with this. Please don't offer me something that, no, it's a snake oil. I don't believe in that stuff. And just like you, I would have experiences with it. My cousin, his name is Boyd Truman. He's very large in the essential oil industry, just in general. Look him up. He is the creator of Symphony of the Cells. He travels the world teaching classes. He's been in the essential oil industry for 26 plus years. He has 8 children, raised them all on essential oils. He studied abroad. He's used everything under the sun as far as essential oils go. And he's the one that introduced us to the essential oils. And all I knew about him is he was holistic, and they shopped at Whole Foods, and they were just that weird family. And, you know, I was not raised like that at all. And so I was hesitant, but because I had 4 children and because he had 8 children, and I saw how healthy they were, and I saw that this was a lifestyle for them, I was like, sure, it's natural. How can it hurt? And surely enough, we started using them. We started slowly making them a lifestyle. And 8 years later, I'm teaching around the world, and I love teaching these to people because I think it's the best kept secret out there. I think people really just don't completely understand how powerful nature is when it comes to health. I think we've gotten stuck in the one frame of mind of just pay your copay, just go to the doctors, let's run over to CVS really quick. Now, I'm not opposed to that. Not opposed to our doctors. I'm not opposed to medication. I'm not opposed to any of that stuff. It has just become our first answer. and it shouldn't be. It should be the last resort. And we need to change our mindset. We need to look at nature again. We need to see that 150 years ago, we didn't have synthetics. We didn't have a lot of the drugs that people are using nowadays that are actually causing more issues. They had nature for the 150 years ago and all the hundreds and hundreds of years before that. Nature was medicine. That is how it was used. The beauty about using nature today is we have so much science under our belt. We have more evidence. We have names for these chemical constituents that are growing in these plants, twigs, trees, seeds. However, we're getting these natural resources to help our body. So why is natural health such a big deal now? It's because we have science behind it. We have doctors behind it. We now have medical industries that are looking into natural resources, and that's exactly what our bodies need nowadays. Because I know plenty of people that are, they rely on their medications, and that is their right. That is their choice to go that route in their health, in their healthcare choices. But we do need to change our mindset. We need to change our lifestyles. And so for me personally, when I saw a huge health difference with my children, mind you, they have not missed a school day for about 6 years. Okay. We've had some in and out stuff, but their attendance record is pretty impeccable. We didn't have that before I was starting to use essential oils. And so that's got to say something. And it's not just me. There are people, hundreds, thousands, millions of people who have the same opinion that I do because it works for them. And so I want to break down really quick, just a few things, a few ways you can use essential oils that will help with boosting the immune system. Now, I'm going to give the big question that everybody seems to have when it comes to just learning about essential oils. What is the point of essential oils? Just think about that for a second. Because it's a big hype now. I mean, it's, you know, it's become a bigger hype in the past few years, and people are going more green and going the more natural route. But what is the point of essential oils? And here's the point. Here is the big aha. Oh, that's what they're for. The point of essential oils is to lessen your toxic intake and to lessen your chemical and synthetic intake. That is the point. That's what we use them for. The more you are able to lessen the chemical, the toxins in your life, the harmful toxins and chemicals that we are taking in from our food, from our medication, from our cleaning products, the bigger your immune system is going to be, the stronger your immune system is going to be. So how do we use essential oils? I have actually a little PowerPoint for you guys because I love Shanna so much. I wanted to impress her. So I decided to put a little something together for you guys. I hope it's okay for me to share my screen. I'm going to put this up for you. And can you see that? Can you see this okay?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Okay. So boosting our immune system with essential oils. Now I'm going to go ahead and go back to that first question. So what do we use essential oils for to lessen the toxins in our life, right? Okay. Now I'm going to go to this question. How do we boost our immune system naturally? It's the same exact answer. You have to lessen the toxins in your life. You have to lessen the harmful stuff that's coming into your system. So they work hand in hand together. So essential oils are going to essentially help with that. Okay, so let's start with just some real basics, okay? So if we're using essential oils, these are the three ways. Now I use doTERRA because I trust doTERRA. It's backed by doctors. They test every essential oil up to 54 times. I love where they're sourced. The sourcing has everything to do with it. The soil, the weather, all of that has everything to do with it. It's all science-based. doTERRA is a science-based company. And so I trust them. You can go to sourcetoyou.com and look at all of their testing with their oils. And because of that, we can take them internally, which I'm going to talk about in just a moment. So just keeping that as like a precursor to what we're going to talk about in just a moment. So Aromatically using essential oils is going to highly heighten the strength of your immune system. Now, whether you're diffusing things like cinnamon, cassia, citrus oils, all of those are wonderful and powerful, and they naturally just kind of kill the bad stuff in the air. They protect your home is what they do. Not only are they protecting your home, they're protecting your body when you're breathing them in as well. And like I said, it's science. There's chemical constituents that grow and dwell within these essential oils. And so when you are breathing them in, it goes into that olfactory in your brain, and it switches things onto your brain so that you're helping with sleep, helping with emotional balance, but also cleaning out in your body what shouldn't be there, hence helping with the immune system there. So aromatically is a very popular way that you can use your essential oils. Topically, using them topically is such a strong way. And this is one of the more popular ways people like to use their essential oils. If you've had a massage, you may or may have not had essential oils applied to your back when you've been using essential oils. Mostly they use that so you're having the aromatic properties, everything smells like a spa. Yes, your mindset goes to a calmer place when you smell nice things like spearmint and eucalyptus and some of those nice calming grounding essential oils. So yes, aromatically, like we had just talked about, we'll do that. But when you add topically is also a very powerful way to help with boosting your immune system. My number one way topically is applying a blend we call, called On Guard. I'm sure you guys, many of you have heard about it. We apply it to the bottom of my children's feet every night before bed. Now, that may sound strange. It's not strange for us because it works. Obviously, my kids are a great example of having a boosted immune system with not missing too much school. I mean, they do really well. And when they do get something or if they catch something, it's rare, but we take care of it with these tools, and I do call these tools. Everybody has their own choice of tools to use. These are the ones that I choose that works for my family. And so topically, using On Guard on the bottom of the feet, cinnamon, peppermint, a lot of different essential oils will help go shoot into the bloodstream and help get to work as far as boosting the immune system. But that is my number one of helping the boosting the immune system of my family, is applying oils on the bottom of the feet topically. And then internally, you had just heard from Shanna of how she had her first experience using an essential oil internally. Disclaimer before I continue with this part of the subject. If you're going to take it internally, I am going to highly recommend, please do not go to Target. Please don't go to Whole Foods and buy an essential oil there and assume that you can take those internally. Absolutely not. That can be hazardous to your health. We don't know what has been tested there. We don't know where they're coming from. That's again why I choose doTERRA, because I know where it's coming from. And because of the scientific background and because of the 150 plus years of all of the doctors put together that study our essential oils, we can share that our essential oils, most of our essential oils, you can take them internally. And in fact, we suggest you take them internally because they do work hand in hand with the body in cleaning out a lot of the blah that's inside the body. And so internally, that's what it's going to help do. My number one choice for internally is citrus oils in your water. Drinking water, of course, is huge. And especially if you're dealing with autoimmune, water is inevitable. That is your cleansing palate right there. You need to be replenishing constantly, using water, hydrating constantly to help put your body into balance. Now, adding some of these awesome natural constituents that are in citrus oils naturally alkaline the body. And so when we're drinking our lemon oil, lime oil, grapefruit oil that are coming from the outside, it comes from the rind. It's not acidic. It doesn't come from the actual fruit, but the white part of that citrus oil, it's a natural cleanser. So drinking that in your water helps to flush a lot of the toxins and a lot of the buildup in the body that shouldn't be there in the first place. And what happens when we have a lot of buildup in our body? We have a weak immune system. And with a weak immune system, we're just being more susceptible to things that are coming our way. So aromatically, topically, internally, some of the easiest ways that you can use doTERRA essential oils, at least for me. As a mother of four kids and using them for the past 8 years, they work. And especially using them this way. Now I'm gonna switch the tone a little bit to lifestyle changes. How can we do little lifestyle changes to help boost our immune system with essential oils? Three easy ways. Change out your household products, change out your personal care products, and of course, Shanna, I'm sure that you just teach and teach to the rafters about nutrition, because nutrition is the home plate of everything in your body. It is natural medicine. It's a natural replenisher in our body. And if you're not paying attention to your nutrition, everything's going to go out of whack with your body. So we're going to talk about this just a little more simplified, okay? So I'm sorry the resolution is not super good on this. I put this together pretty fast. Household products. You would not believe it, and I know Shanna has experienced this before, but we think when we use something like peroxide, ammonia, bleaches, that those are going to kill the bad things, and so hence we're going to keep the sick away. It's the opposite. When your body is exposed to poisons and substances that it doesn't understand, not only are you killing, sure, they're going to clean and they're going to kill certain bacterias, you're going to kill good, bad bacterias and bad bacteria that your body necessarily needs every time that you are cleaning. So if you can turn to a green option, that is huge for your immune system. Your immune system is so much more ready for anything when, again, you're freeing toxins out of your lifestyle, not just from your body, but in your home. And so I love our products. We have awesome lifestyle products that help with that. So for example, the first thing, the On Guard Cleaner Concentrate. I touched just a little bit on On Guard. It is miraculous. Please do some studies on it. It is unbelievable. I use it as my hand spray. I use them as my cleaner of my countertops. I'm diffusing it all the time. It's a big one in our home. And they have an awesome cleaner concentrate that I use, and it makes me like 18 32 ounce bottles that last me like 6 months. It's wonderful. But I also know that it's not hurting my body or my natural bacteria that my body needs. But it is naturally going to take care of whatever is invading my home at the time. Okay, big subject, hand washing, right? Just simple hand washing. Make sure you're doing it. However, keep in mind, and again, this is all mindset, and you just have to get your mind there. We are using a lot of antibacterial products. Sure, I understand why. Problem is, just like when you take medication, medication is foreign to your organic body. It's going to work and help. It's going to help readjust things to a point. But what happens after a while? Our body becomes immune to that, and then we have to up, right? We have to up our medication. Same thing with antibacterial soaps and lotions and sanitizers. When you're using those and applying those to your hands constantly, guess what your body's going to do? It's going to start resisting it. Because now you're going to need a stronger dosage. Now you're going to need more chemicals and harsher stuff, which companies are now making, that's going to get into your bloodstream and, again, hurting your immune system. So I love our hand wash. It's a natural hand wash with that On Guard blend that you can use. But I also will add things like wild orange, cinnamon, rosemary. I will use those essential oils to help naturally clean my hands so that I don't have to worry about if my body is going to become immune to it, because your body cannot become immune to essential oils. Why? Because, again, oils come from twigs, trees, grass, stem, seeds, all of that stuff. And every time they grow, the chemical constituents change just a bit, and it's different every time you get a bottle, every time you're getting a mixture, so that chemically you won't become immune to that essential oil or whatever natural product you're using the essential oil in. Okay, next, candles. I'm going to ruin somebody's day today, and I am so sorry to be that person, but I was that person. I loved candles. I had candles everywhere. I had plug-ins. I had Glade fresheners. I had all that stuff. Now I can't use it. Now I walk into a room with the plug-ins. Shanna, you know what I'm talking about, right?
Oh my gosh, I was the same way. I had all the things when it came to candles and the spray air fresheners and everything, and now my husband knows how sensitive I am to those things. We just found a new dentist in town, and we went for the first time, and he took our daughter first, and he warned me. He's like, Shanna, you are not going to want to sit in that office. You're not going to want to walk into that office. They have plug-ins everywhere. He's like, I couldn't even stand it. And so I use the diffuser now, and I got rid of all my, not naming names, but that store in the mall that really, really smells. I had all their candles. I got rid of all of those.
Yeah. So, I mean, simply just diffusing alone, not only are you getting, aromatic properties, but they're natural aromatic properties that smell good, but it's doing your body good. Anywhere you go, and why is it always the dentist office? Every time do I go to a dentist office, there's plugins everywhere. And I'm assuming it's just so they're not smelling the dentist-y smelling things, which triggered, I get that. But my dentist place, they switched over as soon as I gave them a diffuser, and it calms the patients down at the same time. Right. They liked that. So you can switch that out so easy. And there's so many great different essential oil blends out there. We have like an oatmeal cookie blend that we like to do. We have like a lavender lemonade that we like to diffuse. And my kids have their favorites that they like to diffuse. I have a diffuser in every room. You might call that obsessed. I call that being prepared. Okay. And just being clean everywhere around my home. It's very important to me. And then lastly, just simple things like laundry detergent. I can't smell Tide. I have had a gag reflex from smelling something like Tide before. Now, not back in the day, not before essential oils. When I came into a home of like, you know, the bleaches and the peroxides and all that stuff, I'd go, my house is clean. Now, if I'm smelling things like laundry detergent and those kinds of cleaners, I shut off. I shut down. I feel like I am suffocating. And once you make that lifestyle change, it will happen to you too, because your body is now responding. The body doesn't lie, you guys. The body is telling you exactly what it's experiencing. And so when I'm smelling those things or using those things, my body's telling me I don't like that. And so you go to a greener option and your body appreciates it. Okay, second lifestyle is, of course, your personal products that you're using. I'm assuming there's going to be a lot of women on here. And if there's some men, that's wonderful too. This does apply to you as well. But as a woman, I want you to, here's a challenge to you this week. Write down every product you use before you walk out the door in the morning. Shampoos, conditioners, lotions, makeup, mascara, foundation, deodorant, toothpaste. I want you to write down all of the things you use to hygienically get your body ready for the day. And I want you to add all of those toxins together and wonder, why are we such a sick society? It's because our natural things that are supposed to make us clean are dirty and full of toxins, and they're more harmful than they are beneficial to you. So try switching out for greener options. Our toothpaste is awesome. It's an On Guard toothpaste. The normal toothpaste has a poison control center number on the back of it. That's a little scary, right? Deodorants. Oh, do you guys have a few hours where I can talk about lymph nodes under your armpits that we're putting heavy metals underneath? And I get it. I don't want to be the stinky person in the room. I don't want to be the sweaty one in the room, but I also want to live a long life, and I want to take care of my breasts, and I want to take care of the rest of my body. And your lymph nodes have really big pores that we're putting really heavy toxic things in there. So try to switch it up with something. Even if you want to use your regular deodorant, switch it up. If you're going to stay home that day, try a natural route and just alternate, because I'm not going to sit here, you guys, and tell you that I don't use toxins. I'm getting my hair done later. Okay. Like, I got my nails done this week. I do like some of those toxins in my life. It's part of my lifestyle, but if we can significantly decrease it, it will be life-changing for you. Even just a little bit will make a huge change. Skincare, biggest organ on the body. I know a lot of people that are so interested in eating organic and really living a clean, green lifestyle. But when it comes to skincare, it's like oil of olay. That's what they'll use. Or they'll use the Nivea from the grocery store. Biggest organ. Everything sucks up into your pores and it does go into your body. So don't think that if you're using it topically that it's not going to change your health. It will significantly. I go as far as getting natural makeup. A lot out there. There's a lot of makeup companies that are coming around and really trying to get a lot of the blah out of their products. So please look into those, because that makes a big difference. And then lastly, and Shanna, go ahead, Shan, please.
Yeah, I just have to say, if you have not seen the documentary Toxic Beauty, you've got to invest 90 minutes of your time and watch it. It was mind-blowing to me. It really like focuses on the asbestos found in talc. Namely, in the movie, it talks about Johnson & Johnson, their baby powder, and how it's the asbestos found in the talc has been linked to ovarian cancer. It talks about other beauty products too. Share it with all the women in your life. It is really, I think it's criminal what's happening. Another thing is I use Beauty Counter, which they are a safe, non-toxic skincare and makeup company. They do testing on every batch. They are you can go on and read exactly all of their, you know, all of the results of their testing. They have a never list filled with ingredients that they never put in their makeup or skincare. I just love their stuff. So I'm so glad that there's different options now. I'm so glad that as women that there is more awareness being raised for it. Not enough in my mind. I know women who have changed how they eat, have changed their lifestyle. They see a huge impact in how they feel after they change their skincare and their makeup. For them, that was the missing piece of their puzzle. So just a heads up, this is such an incredibly important topic.
And yes, Beauty Counter is awesome too. So if you can find a rep and work with them, they'll make sure that you get...
I'm actually a consultant, so I can take care of you.
There you go. So you can talk to Shan. She will hook you up right there. Awesome. Okay, so nutrition is not a surprise. This is something we hear about all the time, but I don't think we take it as seriously as we should, because especially those that are dealing with autoimmune situations, this is a game changer for people with autoimmune. I mean, you need to completely reset your body so that it is, you're giving it the fuel that is necessary to help it. And so really be aware of what you are intake. And then this is just my information if you want to follow me. I've been teaching this for 8 years. I love doing this job. If you want to get started, I'm that person who's just going to show you the way. Start basic. You always want to start basic with something like this lifestyle and work your way up. That's it. That's all I have for you. Any questions?
Thank you so much, Mandy. And you guys have to follow her. She is hilarious and she has some hilarious videos. So I am so honored to call you friend. Thank you so much for your
time.
I love you.
You're spectacular. You guys, you couldn't have a better person, more with more integrity, with more passion. Seeing this transformation of just who you've turned into, it's just talk about taking something that was tragic and difficult for her and just rebuilding it into something amazing. She's the person. I'm very excited for you to get to know Shanna more if you haven't already, and just learn from her, because she has risen herself above many obstacles and is a wonderful person. So I love you.
Thank you so much. I love you too. And as you can tell, as you guys know how passionate I am about the AIP and nutrition and lifestyle and mindset and all the things, you could tell Mandy's just as passionate about health and wellness and essential oils. Again, thank you for sharing your knowledge with us today.
Absolutely. All right. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions at all. If I don't know the answer, I will text Mandy and get the answer for you. If you have any questions about safer beauty, safer skincare, I can help you with that. You can feel free to comment below or email me hello@shannanemrow.com. I'll put that down below as well. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And while you're down there, please hit subscribe. I publish new videos every Wednesday. And if you don't want to miss any, please be sure to subscribe. Have a wonderful week.